Good day. My name is Nene du Plessis and I'm a South African occupational therapist that's passionate about hippotherapy. Today we will be talking about
hippotherapy and size. About size, the height of the therapist and the size of the horse and whether it matters.
Hippotherapy uses the movement of a horse as a therapy tool to reach functional goals, and it is used by occupational therapists, physiotherapists, and speech and language pathologists who have extra training in hippotherapy after they got their degree within their various disciplines. So Tabitha asked an interesting question.
Does size matter at all?
So yes, Tabitha, size do matter when you choose a therapy horse, and size matter with regards to the size of the client, and the size of the horse must match to one another. Then also the size of the horse must match the size of the therapist. So now let's explain that. The therapist must be able to handle the client, reposition the client, and reach the client to support the client in a way that's both safe and it's not going to cause harm to either the client or the therapist. So if it's a smallish child that needs a lot of support on a very high horse, the therapist is going to work in this position, and there's no way that you can sustain this while walking beside a horse for a prolonged period. So the size of the horse must link to the size of the therapist. With regards to the client and to the horse match, one of the theories behind hippotherapy is that the rider's pelvis, when he sits on the walking horse, mimics the movement that a human pelvis makes when you are walking on the ground. So on a walking horse, you have forward and backwards movement, you have side to side movement, and you have rotation. Then also you have vertical displacement, how bouncy the horse is. So this kind of cycle must correlate with the size of the client. The size of the horse impacts the kind of sensory input and how close this sensory impact is to the normal walking gait of that person.
So the size of the horse and the size of the client must match.
Then also the width of the horse, how wide the horse is, makes a big difference. Now, sometimes we want a broader base of support so that we can put the hands down as well as to help with balance and to be more stable. But as soon as that is too big, we have movement problems, and that's going to lead to problems in the hips with internal rotation and can cause a hollow back. So many different things come into play, and a therapist needs to check all these movements, how it influences the client, even after you chose a horse. So it's important to remember that hippotherapy is a complex intervention. Many different factors need to be taken into consideration when you choose the size of the horse for a specific client. And therefore, you cannot only have one horse to give therapy, because that will exclude quite a lot of your clients if you don't have a variety of horses, and if you can't choose from the variety of movement and sizes of horses for each client. So the client horse match is quite an important part of any hippotherapy setting.
If you like my videos, please click the subscribe button so that more people can have access to my videos, or give me a thumbs up so that we know you like it.